Yeah, dude, where you at?
I'm at the apartments. Can you pick me up?
Yes, yes, yes.
Yeah, thanks.
I was telling you, you remember the cops, you know, caught us for fishing?
Yeah, I remember.
So we need to get you a fishing license, okay?
Okay.
I'm gonna see if my lawyer is in town.
Okay, you have a lawyer? Nice.
Yeah. Let's go and see. Let's check it out if he's there at the hall. Do you mind stepping out? He's gonna be here.
Okay.
Draper, here, meet my friend Sonam, and Sonam, meet my attorney, Mr. Draper.
Hi there.
Hello.
Look at his suit. That's a $10,000 suit.
Oh my god.
No, it's just $9,999.
Yeah, dude, you gotta leave that dollar for the cashier, you know.
Yeah, this is
the girl that needs the licenses.
Okay, I can manage that.
See, listen, Sonam, this guy is the topmost attorney in the city right now.
Okay.
Listen up. Yep. Even if the devil himself takes you to the depths of hell, this guy can get you out, you know. But you gotta pay the guy. For the right amount, he'll get you out of fucking hell.
It sounds great.
Yeah, I don't take money. It's like, yeah.
Okay. You don't take money. Yeah. So you will be doing it for free.
I get enough salary, and whenever I'm low on, you know, cash, I just go to a judge and, you know, rant in front of him. He gives me like 5,000 and I'm paid.
But you know, if you gotta take him, you need to pay his retainer fees.
Okay.
Yeah. So DA of mine, Vivi-chan, she fixed me up with some police officer. So I get two salaries now, you know.
Oh,
perfect, dude. Salary with mine, salary, my organization salary, you will be like the boss. I'll pay you too.
Yeah, exactly. To spend at casino, yeah.
Yes.
Did someone catch you? No?
Yeah, some guy with the fucking ranger department.
Yeah, ranger department.
Not even a real cop, dude.
Okay, you're not supposed to say that, but okay.
So you guys done with the thing? You guys
gave her a temporary license because servers are not working. That's between us. I will register it later on. She can just use it. Okay.
Got something for you. Yeah. Wait, for helping us out. You know,
I'll keep it
on the ground.
No,
it's not about the money. If I had money, that would be like fucking corruption, dude. He helped us, right? So he's gotta take it. Did you take it, Sonam?
No,
I have it.
Okay, alright. Okay, that's your 500 for a wheel spin.
No, it's okay. So I don't need that.
Dude, you're just being humble with us.
I don't need that much money right now.
Curry been saying you've been printing money, bro.
I hope. Like, I wish I was doing that, but you know. I'm not
dude, you don't blow all of it up on the fucking this thing, dude. Wheel spin and the fucking blackjack. You know, save some of it.
Just gave me 15
minutes. I heard
what the fuck?
Yeah,
some guy was talking about getting businesses.
Thank you. Yeah, actually, a lot of businesses are coming up, so I'm just thinking about.
Yeah, save it, bro. Save it. I'd like to see you become a big man. Like, yeah,
somehow
wear
you have
a fucking $30,000 suit.
I don't know how, but people like know me, so. I just used that thing
look
to
at
scam
the fucking
for 10-20,000.
Yeah.
And
look at that fucking hair, dude. What do you use for gel? Concrete? Look at that. Power went out, damn.
Yeah, the water went out.
Yeah, let's go, let's roll.
Okay.
See you, Don. Thanks for helping out.
Yeah.
Nice meeting you.
Hey. Yeah. I'll see you every time we fuck up.
Yeah, I hope so.
Yeah, see ya. Dude, get in.
Yeah, sure. Oh, you have a company.
Yeah, she wants to go to the pillbox, it seems.
Yeah. Hey, Sonam, what's up?
I'm good. What about you?
I'm fine, Sonam. How are you doing?
I'm doing great.
By what you doing great?
See, new city, new world, so I'm loving it.
I'm going great too, by the way. You know why? Because I have two girls sitting in my car right now. How about that?
That's great.
Actually, yeah, that's great. You are actually a good, humble person. You actually help everybody. That's a good thing. You know, mainly people don't help anybody. There are so many selfish people in the city. But you, yeah, you come forward, you are giving me list to billbox, and I would like to thank you by why bottom not, of my not? Heart.
You know, what's a girl name, comes man, and asks me for a lift.
Girl
I
come?
Lift
what do you mean, hello?
That's how it works. You know, two pretty girls in my car, what the fuck?
Come, okay. By the way, Sonam.
My name is Dhananjay, by the way.
Dhananjay.
What's your good name, ma'am?
Yes.
My name, Muni. Your name is Dhananjay?
Yes, yes, sister. Why?
You know, I had a school friend. His name was Dhananjay too. And he was very close friend of mine.
Nice.
But he's
dead
now.
So maybe we can be close friends here. Oh, fuck. Maybe, you know, he's not dead. He's alive inside you.
Yeah, his feelings inside me. Yeah.
Alright, we gonna split it. We'll go fishing. Alright?
Yeah.
Take care, Munni.
Take care.
Can I join you guys? If you don't mind.
What's your name, dude?
My name's Trey Cole.
What's up, Trey? Nice to see you.
Yes,
Dude, Trey, have you ever gone fishing?
Yes, I have been to. I have done fishing. Is it your first time, guys?
Mine is first time.
Oh.
I finally got a license. I had no license for fishing. Zen is showing me how to fish.
Where from both of you?
I came right out of the South Pole.
Oh my god. Really, Zen? I'm from India,
I'm like that. I'm from India too. But before the city, I was stuck in the South Pole. Then I got to Africa out of that. Then I came, took a flight to this place.
What is that?
From south to north, you went all around the world. Wow.
People I trusted took me to the South Pole and tried to kill me there.
What?
I'll tell you the whole story some other time.
Okay.
By the way, I'm from Los Angeles.
Oh, you're
awesome,
from...
dude.
Nice. I've been a
come
police
down from the
there.
States. That's good. Trey, you got a really nice stash, bro.
Mustache?
Yes, it's awesome.
Thank you.
You look like a fucking cowboy. I can't grow hair on my face for shit, dude. When
okay,
it comes
man.
Out, I tried growing. When it comes out, it's like all patchy and shit.
See. So which part
that
of India are you from?
I'm from Goa.
Oh, Goa. Oh man, Goa,
yes.
Nice.
But
Goa.
Actually, my native is Chandigarh. But I used to stay mostly in Goa.
Did you taste Feni?
Yes, yes. See, that is why this Sonam trusted me to, you know, be with me because she's also from Goa. So she thought I would be a good guy.
Nice, nice.
He's the first guy I ran into, in this city.
Yeah.
So I had no other option but to trust you.
Coincidence.
Yeah. It's a beautiful mountain there.
Yeah, I was about to say that.
I was in the South Pole, so I had to take a ship from South Pole to the Cape in South Africa. Then from there, I traveled to this place. I directly took a flight to this place.
So you might have traveled all around the world, right?
Yeah. From the depths of the Middle East to the fucking Amazon jungle, everywhere.
Oh my god.
I was a kid. I was like, a local TV personality, sort of like the child of the wild.
Oh my god.
On National Geographic. Fuck yeah, I got a fish. You know why?
Yeah, I remember
so
something.
So after that,
watching. Yep.
So when I grew up, they fucking kicked me off because I wasn't cute no more.
Oh. It was a child versus wild afterwards.
Yeah. So
did
they
you,
got a new child.
From your
fuck
own
him.
House?
Fuck that child. By the way. So then what happened as I grew up, I started taking this, you know, freelancing kind of jobs, you know, where people wanted to go to the wilderness and I used to guide them and be, you know, the guy who protects them and lets them know. And as time went by, one day I got a, you know, very mysterious call. So then this guy tells me that they like found a location of a treasure in the South Pole, okay? And I have to take his team to the this thing, cave, in a South Pole cave. So we go, I lead them there, we find the cave, we, you know, all the fucking traps and all set up, and we finally find the treasure and we come out. And then these guys, you know what they tell me? Zen, you gotta go inside the cave because they couldn't fix up one of the wires. And they give me a dynamite in hand and they tell me, like, come dude, go inside, fix it, and we'll wait for you outside. As soon as I get in, I can blow it up, dude, with me inside.
My god. How did you survive then?
Dude, I got trapped under a bunch of stone. Okay, luckily they only could blow up the entrance to the cave. Because I was smart enough to do that. I was the guy who rigged the fucking dynamite. And then, I dig up myself out of the cave. I fucking eat penguins. Cute ass penguins. You don't know what that does to a man like me, dude, when you kill penguins. Just because I had to eat. And then I take a ship from that place, because you know a ship comes to the South Pole once every 6 fucking months.
You're truly
a
survivor.
So I sneak onto that ship.
Yeah.
I came here and I find out that the person who was on the phone is in this fucking ship.
Oh my god.
So I don't know who he is. Yeah. I don't know what he sounds like. Nothing about him. But I gotta go find him. To take out a guy like that, I need to get rich, because he would be rich as hell to, you know, finance an expedition to the fucking South. So I need to get rich. That's the story about me.
It was really an adventurous story. Like, you are truly a child versus wild. No more a child though.
Yeah, dude.
Oops. Sorry, I got too excited.
Dude, you fuck. The fish went away, dude.
Same here, I got...
You fuck. That could have been a fucking whale, bro.
My god, it was very difficult to hold on to that rod, you know. So it happened, I'm really sorry.
Maybe it was,
dude, I think you fucking took out the tooth or something.
Oh, Mr. Jin, it was a rock maybe.
But you survived a dynamite, you could survive one punch of mine.
Yeah, she got a point.
Dude, girls be strong nowadays.
You suit, by the way. Make a suit.
Yeah, I needed to, you know, look little bit, you know, sneaky, like a detective, so that it suits my, you know, personality.
Yeah, you look like a Sherlock Holmes ripoff.
Oh my god.
Rip off! Oh my god. Some nasty jobs, but you told me you don't wanna know those, right?
I am already in trouble. I don't want to get in trouble more in this city.
Shark.
Yeah, you like reggae shark over, maybe shark.
Know some ganja. That's why you like him.
My head spins.
Look at that farmer's market.
Oh my god.
Trey, check it out.
That was the species I studied. Cannabis.
What? Are you fucking kidding me?
Yep, I'm a herbologist, you know. And
so you studied this?
Yep.
Oh, dude, your surname too is fucking Ganjawala, dude. Yep. You were destined for this shit.
Yeah, my great-great-grandfather, you know, they were farmers.
Oh, fucking ganja farmers. Oh, fuck yeah, dude. You are a good person to hang around with, bro. Nice.
Look, smell it. It's so potent.
Nice. Trey, what do you have to say about this? Smell it, bro.
I don't want to smell it because I'm going to be giving interview in BCS.
Dude, weed is fucking legal, bro. Fuck them. Fuck them, guys.
Is it legal here? I don't think so.
Weed is legal in this country?
It's you can smoke some amount of weed if it's
for personal use.
The prescription.
Got it. For medical purposes.
It is not allowed. Yeah.
That is great.
Because back in India,
we have a herbologist with us. She'll give us fucking prescription.
You mean it's legal in Goa or India?
No, it's nowhere legal.
The other hand, I have heard that UP legalized marijuana.
Uttarakhand is the first state to legalize for medical purposes.
That's it.
But it's not that's how you think.
That's a start.
It's a good start though, but that's long way to go for legalizing it.
You guys smoke weed?
Yep, I am a researcher in cannabis, so I definitely don't. For my research purpose, for my everything.
So you just smoke it when you're doing research, right? Other than that, you won't do it.
Yeah, I research
for
whole day long, so it's there whole day.
So you spend your time you spend all your day in research room?
Yep, I'm a herbologist, right? So I research on this plant. That's my job. I got a degree in biology, that is PhD degree, and then after that we have to study a specific plant, or we have to master in specific thing, right? So I took a cannabis plant.
What were your parents thought when you told them about you gonna be studying cannabis?
They were very happy about it. You know, my ancestor, not ancestor as such, my great great grandfather was a farmer. He used to be a cannabis farmer. They were very happy, finally someone in our family is doing something great for around.
Yes, sir.
To tell you all the truth, the study in cannabis got me into trouble.
To the trouble?
It's a long story.
Okay, no problem.
I can tell you if you're ready to
both
listen.
Both of us, everybody has a fucking long story. What?
Yep. You know, I as I told you, I'm a biologist. So, I was into this study of cannabis. For around 2 years, I studied that plant. And finally, I made a breakthrough discovery. You know what it was? It was a cure for cancer.
Ooh, okay.
So, what happened, I thought this particular cure would be the game changer in the fields of medicine. Because finally, it's a cure for cancer. Nobody has found it.
Isn't smoking injurious to lungs?
It's not smoking as such, the extraction of cannabis doesn't come in one format, the extraction, the oil or it's in different format. What I was researching was in extraction of cannabis plant. So that was it, and in fact the cure wasn't even public. I started getting this calls. Some strange people started calling me, blackmailing me to keep my mouth shut. I can't, tell this to people. I can't be public about the discovery. So I got too many death threats. So I tried taking help from so many people, but it didn't work out. And finally, I had to leave that city. Just to be safe. So let's see now. Hopefully one day we can make it legal all over the world.
Weed can be consumed by a human per day?
There is no specific amount. It depends upon a human body. In fact, whatever molecules are there inside the weed are there present in our human body. It's called endocannabinoids. That's there in our own system. Our own system produces it.
That's some knowledge.
It's not like it's a foreign substance going inside your body. It just enhances your own cell, molecules inside the body.
So you mean to say our body makes that whatever is there
whatever's
in
weed.
Awesome.
What
more
amount
of
weed person gets high?
It depends. The substance what makes a human body, human beings high is THC. So it need not be only THC you need in your body. There is something called as CBD, which has a medical value of it. And that's not psychedelic substance.
What is CBD though?
CBD is cannabinoid. That is what I'm talking about. Like, it's already present in your body. Cannabinoid. Supposing you have some medical condition, it is that time when you need cannabinoids. For example, it's great for curing cancer. That is what. It develops their immune system. So it helps in healing them. So that is the basic use of
for
it.
For a good purpose, not the just for... We don't need to make it a habit, right?
No, it's not only for recreational, you know. It can be used for medical. There are lots of uses of it. You know, first canvas in this world was made with cannabis plant.
Dude, like it or not, did you get the banknotes in inventory?
I'll just check. Yep, it says band of notes.
Yeah, so like it or not, you are a fucking criminal now.
Oh my god, is it illegal? Ah, yeah.
Yes, it is. You have to start doing stuff that you don't even like. Just because you have those things.
I did stuff which I like. It didn't go very well.
Okay. So you let me know when you come back next into the city. And I'll take you to meet my friend Curry. If he's good with you, we'll let you know
secret. Selling exotic fish was fine. What are you putting me into?
It's just pain pills, dude. Just pain pills.
What do you mean pain?
Painkillers. Painkillers.
You're selling drugs now?
Yeah, somewhat. Yes.
My God, I can't fall into that.
Okay, but then how you gonna get rid of the notes? That's the only way to get rid of those notes. So, otherwise you can just throw them off.
No, I don't want to.
But
I need money to
survive.
See,
yes, that is what. In the end, everybody needs money. So,
selling
you come into the city next time, you hit me up. And if you like, I'll show you around. Maybe my guy Curry can, you know, help you out.
At the end of the day, I'm not bothered about legal or illegal thing. I'm just bothered about being safe or not. Like, I want to be safe.
Yeah, you'll be kept safe. No worries. We'll talk to each other once you get in again. Nice meeting you today.
Same, yeah.
Let me know.
Yeah, bye-bye.